quite a few of you stopped me here on the way in to say how much you gained from this morning's session. I'm very, very happy about that, because what I try to do in any time that I talk is to add perhaps something to a person's spiritual background that they can use to not only better understand life, but to better work with the people that they are working with, whether at their church or their counseling office, their healing center, wherever it might be. Now, let me preface what I'm going to say with just a few words. I have taught everything from astrology and alchemy to Zen and Zoroastrianism, with meditation halfway in between. And I've gone around the spiritual block many, many times. People ask me from time to time, especially in the last few years, your organization is at the forefront of all of these metaphysical activities. What is it that you attribute this to? Have you prayed? Have you visualized? Have you appealed to angels? Have you appealed to spirit guides? Have you gained instruction from ascended masters? My answer, none of the above. Well, isn't that the way it's done? And my answer is, for me, no. Well, then what have you done? I've done nothing. Well, what do you mean you've done nothing? You've put in 40, 60, 70, 80 hours a week. No, I just hang around and let it happen. I'm serious. I'm not being humble. I'm not expressing anything that would fall under the category of humility. I am telling you, I have not prayed, not visualized, not done any of the things that come under the label of what we teach, under the label of New Thought. I haven't done any of the occult things. Appeal to ascended masters. I haven't gone after spirit guides, angels, all of these popular things. So what is it? I can only tell you this, and what I'm going to explain to you is that many, many years ago, in a state of meditation, something happened where suddenly the words of St. Paul took over. Let the mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus.